Hi and welcome to this Tentipi series about wintertime camping. Camping out with your Nordic tipi in the cold and snow is a fantastic experience. Here are a few things you should know before you head out. If the snow depth is more than 20 centimeters, your best option is to pack the snow to make a hard, even floor of snow to pitch on. This can be done with snowshoes or a snowmobile. We're using skis and a shovel in this example. Be sure to make the packed area larger than the tent. Bring out the measuring cord, the mounting cross, and snow pegs. Perform a standard tentipi pitch by placing the mounting cross in the center of the area you just packed. Put a steel peg through the mounting cross and pull the measuring cord over the peg. Following one of the seams of the mounting cross, pull out the cord so it lies loose on the ground and put the snow peg at the number that represents your tent. For this instruction, we use the Sapphire 9. Using this method, place 8 snow pegs symmetrically in a circle. Bring out the canvas from its bag. Unfold the canvas and place it so each ground strap leads to a snow peg. Dig a small ditch in the snow where the snow peg was placed. Make it long enough to fit the peg and a couple of decimeters deep. Make a loop with the ground ring and fasten it around the snow peg. Bury the peg horizontally and pack the snow over the peg firmly and let it freeze for 15 to 30 minutes before you raise the tent. The colder it is, the less time you have to wait. You can use a plank or a thick branch as well. Assemble the central pole. Raise the tent normally by inserting the central pole into the cap that's located in top of the Nordic tipi. If you intend to use an Elfell stove with the tent, make sure to open up the chimney opening in the ventilator cap at this point. You won't be able to reach it later on. While standing in a door opening, carefully raise the Nordic tipi and place the central pole in the middle. Be sure to do it carefully so the snow pegs won't be pulled out of the snow. To ensure that the central pole does not move or sink down in the snow, put a cross made of wooden planks or a piece of plywood under the central pole. We use a tentipi pole plate, but depending on the ground material, you may need something larger to keep the pole from sinking. Tighten the ground straps, and make sure to tighten all straps equally to get an even tension. Use the reinforced edging as a snow flap by folding it outwards. Put a thin layer of snow on it to keep it firmly to the ground and to keep cold air from blowing into the tent. Don't put too much snow on it, it will strain the central pole. If your model have air intakes in ground level, use snow pegs to open them up. If you are pitching your tent in less snowy conditions, with a snow depth of only a couple of centimeters, it's better to remove as much snow as possible and pitch the tent as you would in summertime. Just remember to use steel pegs, as pegs of other materials may not support being hammered on. Pegs will freeze into the ground, so don't hammer the peg down too far. Leave it a couple of centimeters up, so you can give it a good bang to break the ice around the peg once you want to remove it.